Ready?
Yeah.
All right. So have you seen this trailer before?
No, I don't think so.
You excited?
Oh, like, yeah.
It's a dangerous world, isn't it?
I don't know. There is a dark side to nature. Just invented ways to endure. Against all odds.
Storm was in the movie. T. Swift's got a song in this movie? Oh, shit.
One of the funniest things we did was in the story, the girl catches a fish. It's her dad and the young version of the actress. They're out fishing and they catch a fish. Most people might not know this, but you can't just have a live fish on camera because it's live fish. If it's out of water, it's... you're exposing it. It's you know, it's cruelty to the fish. We came up with this idea of buying a fish, a dead fish, cutting it open, and I bought some cat toys off of Amazon. That it's the, what is it called, like the frisky fish or something. It's a cat toy. It's a foam fish that shakes around. So I went multiple times to the fish market and bought redfish. And opened them up, took all the innards out, took these fish toys, put them inside of a condom, tied the condom shut so it's waterproof because it's a battery-powered little toy, put the condom-wrapped cat toy inside the fish, sewed it up with a needle and thread, and then fish gets tied to the end of the hook, fish goes in the water, you pull out the fish, you know, it gives it enough movement to make it look like it's not a dead fish. So, yeah, it was definitely a thing. Yeah, I don't know if it made it in the movie or not, but we definitely did that. There was multiple dead fish bought on this movie.
Has the sheriff's department shut down your engine?
We did some, a lot of Atmo that was on the water. While they're driving the boats around, they had a big police chase in boats. And that was a bit of a challenge for sure, because you're normally doing Atmo on land. You can walk around, place your smokers out where you want to put them and everything. And, like, you know, you're on a boat, well, you can't swim with a smoker. So we had a team actually on that day. It was actually 2 days. A team of three boats, all with their own captain and two effects guys. Each boat probably had, like, two regular foggers that we use and then a lawnmower fogger. So we're kind of working around production wherever they had their boats coming through. We would have to set up, find the wind, have a boat, you know, on the far end of the canal, one boat behind in case of change. And we're constantly dancing around production with our boats, trying to get smoke into the scene. So that was a big challenge that you don't normally have to, I've never seen on a movie before. Normally you just have fog in the air. Low-lying fog would be something where you're trying to create like a morning mist. That was the DP's favorite saying. Justin, can we get the morning mist? She was English. And so it's kind of create like a more of a early morning when you look out in a field and you see the waters evaporating. You get a little haze on top of the field. Kind of catches in the grass, I guess.
I was better off learning from the marsh.
We actually did something kind of different. They wanted to create waves on a beach out in Fountain Blue State Park, and it wasn't an ideal location to make waves. It was kind of shallow, and they were worried that day it would be, if it was too calm, they wouldn't have any waves. So we actually went out and we did a test, and the solution was, since the water was only at its deepest, 6 feet deep maybe, there was no way to get any kind of a wave machine in. So we actually used Matt's wake boat and would drive it offshore back and forth, creating waves from the boat to make them land on shore, just so that they didn't have, like, the water wasn't too still. So we did some boat effects that way.
Just invented ways to endure. Against all odds.
against all odds.
The way they set it up is big rectangle pool, I guess, and they green screen half of it off. So at all times, the camera's only looking into that corner of the pool. So the way they kind of tie it all together is in close-ups, camera's kind of just looking in at the water. So for that, it's, you know, all practical effects. You got to have the water come in. You got to have the waves agitating the water. You got to have the rain and everything like that. So then when they drop down and look out, they're still seeing into the green. They can replace that with whatever they want, you know, ocean view, storm clouds, everything like that. And then there's no way to recreate the movement of the boat and to give the actress something to interact with. So if you were just have a boat on green screen, you wouldn't have all the other things going on. And you know, they're filming her in a storm, and we made that storm for her. We just had our basic condor rig out there for rain. Rain stands out on the end of a condor, call it an antler rig. Our big super fans out there, two of them creating multiple wind directions, I guess. Our big water cannons, which are big, I don't know, 70, 80 gallon tanks that we fill up going over the pool. Our wave maker, actually, we had to do a big modification for, because normally we would make our wave machines and they standalone units that would go and sit in the pool or whatever we're filming in. And it's a large drum that's on a offset. So when it spins in an oblong direction. So it comes up and makes a wave and comes down. But this pool was 14 feet deep. So we couldn't exactly just put the wave machine in the pool because it has to sit water level. So some of our guys who are very skilled and smarter than me designed a system so that the wave maker would actually attach to the front of a pettibone forklift. We came out, used a LiDAR scanner, scanned the front of the pettibone to get all the exact measurements and everything like that. And they actually designed a clip almost so that our pettibone would come in, clip into our giant wave maker, and we could hoist it up and drop it in the pool and raise and lower it. And it wasn't until the day before we filmed it, actually, the two met back up. We were able to clip right in. It was crazy how precise the measurements and everything were for the thing to actually work in order to get that in there and clip in. So yeah, that was by far the biggest effects day we had for the movie. It was pretty impressive.
Am I your girlfriend now?
Do you want to be?
I know feathers. But the other girls don't know feathers.
All right then.
Yeah, The Leaves was an interesting thing because it was something that came up early on in prep. That was one of the first conversations we started to have was, you know, can you guys make something for this shot? We wanted to see swirling leaves around while they're having this romantic moment. And it was something that was kind of funny because originally when we talked about it, it was like, oh yeah, we can totally do that. We'll just put a couple fans and blow some leaves around. You know, someone had seen an internet video of a silk getting blown around by some fans and like, you know, oh yeah, that'll be easy. When we started working on it, it wasn't nearly as simple as that. To be able to create a vortex of wind outside that's consistently spinning around, it was a lot of trial and error, I guess. So, you know, you're in the shop, you're messing around with fans, you're trying to do something, you know, there's always the guy who walks by and is like, oh, hey, what about this? And sure enough, that happened. And we wound up a tank out in the shop, just sitting out in the yard. And someone's like, hey, we want to try this tank and put your fans inside the tank. So eventually what we came up with was around about 2-3 foot high circle of plexiglass. And in that plexiglass, we had multiple leaf blowers. And then that were pointed in opposite directions to give it a swirl. And then we also created a hopper that we could kind of hit a button, turn another fan on and blow some leaves in there. So we ended up with the circle wall of plexiglass with leaf blowers inside of it to spin the initial leaves and create the vortex. And then we set up an additional 12 different fans all pointing inward. So you had this vortex of wind that's spinning the leaves, and then you had other fans on the outside blowing in to try and keep the leaves in the vortex so they shouldn't spin out. And the tricky part was it was a 360 camera move they wanted to do. So they had the camera on a dolly on a 360 track. Our two actors are in the center, and the camera's going around them the whole time, looking inward and not seeing the rig at all. Definitely one of our biggest challenges was the logistics of working on the boats. It's like a situation that you kind of, it's hard to plan for because you can't just, you know, be on set and be, oh, we need something off the truck, go run on the truck and get this. It doesn't work like that. You're on boats. We would, you know, land at base camp in the morning, load up the boats. You would drive for 10, 15, maybe even 20 minutes out to the location on the boat. And then once you're there, you're kind of there. If you need something, it's just a whole ordeal to get back to the truck and get it. So, in order to know, you know, we asked for 3 boats. We needed 2 guys in each boat. So we need all these smokers, you know, so it's, you're sitting there, you know, did I get the right stuff? Did I get enough stuff? How are we going to make it through the day? And dealing with smoke on the water, you know, same thing. You're on land, you can walk around, move your smoke around, easy peasy, but you're in a boat, you know, you can't just get up and walk. You got to drive the boat wherever you got to go. So there's all the logistics with that. I mean, that by far was definitely one of the hardest things to deal with on the movie, was just all the boat logistics. She loved it. Her and my fiance's mom and whole group of gals went to see it because I guess they all read the books and were really excited about it. She tends not to see most of the movies I work on because she's not into the action, gory type stuff that usually comes with effects work. But this was like a love story, I guess, in a way that, I don't know, she went to go see it. She really loved it, though. But her first question was, when she called me to tell me how good it was, how did you get the birds to do all the things the birds did in the movie? And after 13 years of doing this type of work, I don't think she has a clue what I actually do on movies, because it's definitely not the birds. There were some actual birds on set, but a lot of them were CGI, so we had nothing to do with the birds, Mom. I'm sorry.